Mr. Speaker, I rise today in opposition to Senate Bill 279. As both a mom and a public official, I know that it is our duty to protect the most vulnerable and most valuable public resource, our children. For me, advocating for environmental regulation is all about protecting clean air and clean water for all Pennsylvanians. Yet here in this chamber over the past 10 months, I have watched us repeatedly choose to put the wants and needs of big oil and gas companies over our children, our families, and Pennsylvania's workers. I oppose Senate Bill 279 because it will prevent much-needed oil and gas regulations on conventional drillers from becoming law. This attempt to derail common sense regulations came after nearly 30,000 public comments and an exhaustive review process. So exhaustive, in fact, that David Hess, the former Secretary of the Department of Environmental Protection under two Republican governors, called it the most extensive public review and comment process ever undertaken by the Department of Environmental Protection and the Environmental Quality Board since those agencies were first formed in 1971. Yet, Mr. Speaker, it took this chamber a mere 12 days after IRC approved the regs to start dismantling them. Now, we have had heated debates in the Environmental Resources and Energy Committee about this bill. Supporters of this bill like to say that the conventional drillers have been operating in Pennsylvania since the 1800s, that their drilling practices are safe, that they are just mom-and-pop operators that don't deserve the same scrutiny as multinational oil and gas companies. But, Mr. Speaker, the definitions for conventional versus unconventional drilling are fluid, ever-changing. Some extraction activities that were defined as unconventional practices just 10 years ago are now regularly used by conventional drillers. Not all of the sites have been around for hundreds of years. In fact, over a recent five-year period, almost 8,000 new conventional wells were drilled in Pennsylvania. It's fundamentally untrue, Mr. Speaker, that conventional drillers don't use fracking. Many conventional wells require stimulation by hydraulic fracking in order to produce sufficient quantities of gas. The only real difference between conventional and unconventional drillers is how deep they drill and what kind of geological formations they're drilling into. It has nothing to do with the chemicals they use or the impacts on public health. Last year alone, the Department of Environmental Protection reported over 1,024 well violations for conventional drillers. I believe that as legislators, we have a responsibility to protect clean air and clean water for all Pennsylvanians, including the families who live by the drilling sites, the workers who maintain those sites, and the rest of us across the Commonwealth whose air and water quality is inextricably linked through our watersheds. There was a brand new report released today by the Clean Air Task Force and Earthworks that shows that almost 25% of all Pennsylvanians live within a half mile threat radius where they are at risk for high cancer rates, respiratory risks, rashes, low birth weights, and birth defects. Mr. Speaker, before I won my seat, I spent over a decade working in economic development, working with small and medium-sized businesses who ran their operations in a way that was good for the environment, good for their workers, and good for their community. I know, Mr. Speaker, that economic health and environmental health need not be diametrically opposed. A recent report from Carnegie Mellon University and the American Jobs Project shows that Pennsylvania already has 57,000 full-time jobs in clean energy. With the right policy, Pennsylvania's smart building and solar industries alone can support as many as 12,000 new jobs per year. So let's stop catering to big oil and gas companies. I have a stack of over 500 pages of research about the health impacts on living by a drilling site that I'd be happy to share with any colleague in this chamber. It's a mere fraction of the over 500 studies that have been done recently that talk about the public health impacts of living by a drilling site, conventional and unconventional. So let's stop catering to those big oil and gas companies. Let's get to work on policy, on the kinds of jobs that have real promise in Pennsylvania, for industries that are going to be good for workers, good for the environment, and won't pollute our air and water. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.